What's going on with all you beautiful gamers out there? My name is Miles K. Farrington, and I'm here to bring you the news from nowhere. You'll soon be able to play WoW without spending any of your hard-earned money in cash. Blizzard is going to be letting players buy in-game time with gold and buy gold with their real-world money. I know I just said you won't be spending your money, so it'll make sense in a minute. Today they announced the WoW token, which is a token that can be purchased with real money, though a price point has not yet been set, and it can then be sold at the auction house. That's where it starts getting awesome, right? In other words, it effectively lets you buy in-game gold without having to resort to going to one of those kind of sketchy third-party sites, because you know those are the sites that, like, if they were a real place in the real world, if you went there, you'd probably feel like you're going to get stabbed before you got out of there. So it's probably a place you want to stay away from, right? And what this also means is that the in-game tokens can be redeemed for 30 days of playtime. That's where it gets really awesome. So pretty much, if you are a rich player who has a lot of gold sitting around just kind of weighing down your pocket, this is something you're probably going to want to get into, because it means you're going to be feeding your habit without feeding out of your pocket, pretty much, or wherever you happen to keep your wallet. Now, tokens will be sold on the auction house in a buy-it-now format, which means there won't be any bidding wars over them. The prices are going to be set by presumably a supply and demand algorithm, and that's probably going to be handled by Blizzard. So they're going to be the ones determining exactly how much these little things are worth. But once they're purchased, they're soulbound, which is going to mean that you're not going to be able to purchase them and then sell them and then purchase them and sell them. So you're not going to be able to cheese the market or anything, or, you know, rip money off of whoever puts the money into this. I don't really know how WoW works. I admit I don't play it, but this does seem pretty awesome. Any way to make your players play less money is awesome. So, you know, good move on Blizzard's part. Come March 4th, you can expect to hear some big news from Metal Gear Solid 5: The Phantom Pain. I know everyone's really excited to hear about that one. That wasn't sarcasm, even if it sounded like it. On Phantom Pain's official website, a countdown clock has begun that will end on March 4th, 6 a.m. PST. It's going to be 9 a.m. if you're on the East Coast. So, you know, keep an eye out for that one. And the page's teaser is very vague, and it just says, announcement coming soon. What do they have planned for us? Who knows? But the clock will also be expiring, suspiciously, on the 10th anniversary of Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater's release in Europe. And, you know, that's probably not just a coincidence. So, if you want to find out more about the endless saga that's growing ever complicated about snakes eating snakes and solid animals and other liquid animals who cut up robots with their feet swords, just keep an eye out for that one. It'll probably be something big, let's be honest. In other news, Quantic Dream is looking for an actual fashion designer to come on and help them define the characters in their upcoming PlayStation 4 exclusive. We've learned this from a recent job listing. Now, this isn't just helping out those fashion designers who are looking to break into the video game industry. There was actually a pretty interesting quote in there that might lead us to a bit of more information on the game. The quote is, as read, "You'll be in charge of creating a coherent wardrobe for each character in accordance with his or her part, social class, age, but also the game's time period and area." So, I'm breaking the quote a little bit here. This might lead to us knowing that Quantic Dream's next title may take us into the past. Who knows? For all we know, it could go into the future, too. It's kind of vague. The quote continues to say, "Your research and designs will be based on a comprehensive documentation found in the various contemporary artistic and architectural medias." I'll admit, this humble journalist knows nothing about what that means, but it sounds pretty interesting, and it sounds like they're taking this really seriously. So, you know, I wish them the best of luck with it. Moving on, Mortal Kombat X is bringing its bloody beautiful melee of gore and limbs and all that goodness to the iPad, iPhone, iTouch, and Android devices on the 14th of April. On mobile devices, Mortal Kombat X will be free to play and, I quote, "will feature a hybrid of fighting, car collecting, multiplayer team combat, and more." That sounds pretty ambitious for a mobile game, but let's keep reading. Ed Boon also says, "We've expanded the unique cross-connectivity feature that links the mobile and console versions of Mortal Kombat X, delivering unique rewards to all players for simply playing the mobile game." If you're wondering how that's going to work out, Injustice did something very similar when it first came out. There was a little mobile game that was kind of watered down but still enjoyable that you could use to unlock skins and, some other little knickknacks, pretty much, to customize your avatar in the game, which is that thing that your opponent sees when you beat them, or when they beat you, in my case. Anyway, Sony has also announced a handful of titles that will be added to the PlayStation Now streaming service in March. The titles are Infamous 2, Twisted Metal, the 2012 version, R-Type Dimensions, which will feature R-Type 1 and 2, Alone in the Dark Inferno, as well as Operation Flashpoint Red River. That has been your news from nowhere for today, and if you like what we're doing, hit the subscribe button wherever it is. I don't know. Where is it? Anyway, subscribe to the channel, check out our other videos where you can see more of my beautiful face and the beautiful faces of some of our other writers, as well as check out our middleofnowheregaming.com, which is the website, of course, where you can see all of our typing work. Typing work. I'm still getting used to cameras. Anyway, have a good one. Hope you're having a good week.